I'm going to bring you through my strength set this morning. So I'm going to start off with a glute bridge, and then we're going to superset that with dumbbell shoulder press. So my glute bridge is my main focus this morning, but you're supersetting it with an exercise that doesn't really affect the energy or the effort that you're exposing within your glute bridge. So glute bridge is going to work for 10 reps in total, which is a hypertrophy range. We're working for 5 reps, then take a 5-second pause, 3 reps, 5-second pause, 1 rep, 5-second pause, 1 rep, 5-second pause. And this just allows you to get more volume or more energy expenditure from the exercise itself. And then take a few seconds and I'll go over and do my dumbbell shoulder press, for which I'm doing 4 sets. 1 set of 6 and then 3 sets of 10 to 12 reps. So that will change as the weight will change as the reps change. So here. Once I get both exercises done, I'll rest for about 60 to 90 seconds. If you don't need to rest that long, then chances are you're not working hard enough. And next time you go into the resistance sequence, you will feel like you're fatiguing quicker, and set itself is a little harder. So it's important you take your rest as well. So that was my first set done. And I'm going to repeat that 3 more times, more or less. It's 4 total sets for each exercise. So it's 4x10 of the hip thrust, and then now I'm going into 3 sets of 10 or 12 for the shoulder press, which will mean 4 working sets altogether. The weight for the shoulder press will drop now because I'm doing more reps. So with fewer reps, the weight is heavier. With lower reps, the weight will be a wee bit heavier. Again, notice in that exercise I'm working with control. So it's not just about busting the rep out, it's about being able to control and manage the weight as you move it as well. So I was trying to go explosive up and then control on the way down, and that's going to help build up your strength as we go. So 3 more sets of that, then I'll show you what's happening next. So next superset, we've got RDLs, hence the chalk, and we have got lateral shoulder raises as well. So again, working predominantly posterior chain and shoulder movements for my main strength exercises. And just because I'm on a 4-day week program, so every day we just kind of target different areas. We are getting plenty of volume in, so it's typically 4x10, 4x12. So you're getting plenty of volume in and the opportunity to stress the muscle in order to change it and to grow. So again, you superset them, so do 10 reps of your RDL, then more or less move straight over into your lateral shoulder raises. Then you have your rest of between 60 and 90 seconds. Again, the longer you can take for your rest period, being through working harder, and you have the ability to go better for your next set. So that's important too. So final tri-set is kind of just like a burnout set. So I'm going to do banded frog pumps for 30 reps. Then I'm going to move into dumbbell skull crushers for 15 reps. And then I'm going to do banded face pulls for 20 reps. So for these types of exercises, where there is higher reps, the weight is typically a wee bit lower, and you take less rest period between exercises and between circuits, so that you're getting more of a cardiovascular burnout type of feeling. It's a nice way to finish off your circuit. So that's my three exercises. I'm gonna do three rounds of those for higher reps to finish off this morning's workout.